Blackfriars station to catch a train up to Fibre East. I'm heading there to
the next station.
Okay, I'm heading to Blackfriars, meeting up with my friend Mel, who is in London at the moment. I know her from when I lived in Dubai, and yeah, we're heading up to Fibre East together, so I'm really looking forward to that. Trying this whole vlogging thing, so hopefully I'm going to try vlogging today. I'm not very good at talking to a camera on my own in public. I'm on a virtually empty train, so there's not really anyone around to hear me right now, which is why I'm brave enough to do this. But we're getting to a station now, so I'm going to stop and I'll check in with you guys later. We are at the venue now, just heading up to the building, trying to find the entrance. I'm with Mel.
Hi!
Hello! And yeah, sorry, we're panting and puffing. It was a bit of an uphill walk there. We're clearly not very fit people. But almost there, we're nice and early. So, yep. Oh, and there's a queue and to get in.
Not too much of a queue,
that's
okay.
Oh. There we go. Oh. I don't think I've ever seen spinning like that before.
No.
What kind of spinning is that?
Well, we call it the walkway hand spinner. We make them ourselves. These wooden spokes of an IKEA children's bed.
Okay.
100% reclaimed wood.
That's really cool.
Now, because normally when you get a drop spin, it's always hanging weight down.
Yeah.
So when you start spinning, it frequently will break. And because there is it's the other way around, you don't pull, so there's no weight. All you do is this.
Yeah. So you just draft it and then spin?
Yeah.
That's really cool. I'm going to have to come back and have you show me how to do that.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
That's it. In just a couple of minutes?
Yeah.
I will definitely be back. I'm really intrigued.
I'm intrigued by that.
Yeah. Well, many years ago, my wife bought something like that from the internet from the States.
Yeah.
And when it came in, first of all, it appeared to be very, very expensive. It was made out of tropical hardwood.
Oh, geez. Yeah.
It was unbalanced and it was really rattling. So, very annoying thing. So, and being Dutch, we think we can do better.
Yeah,
of course.
But anyway, well, they're very well balanced now. So
yeah, that's awesome.
You need any
that
you actually can ply as well. You can do everything.
Oh, that
basically,
sounds
really what you can do the basic
on a spindle
scene,
or
you can,
wheel,
do,
you can do it on this.
Okay. That sounds really cool.
Much easier.
I was going to say, because I like the idea of learning how to spin, but I've always been put off by spindles because they just seem so cumbersome.
Well, you know why they are called drop spindles?
Because they drop. Yeah.
And I've got one, but I find it snaps because I must be overspinning or something.
Really? Just a couple of minutes and
you'll
get there.
I will definitely be back.
And it's very small movement, so it's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Super.
Oh, very nice. Julie's
Yes. 20 centimeters of the knife.
Okay.
So you pinch it.
Yeah.
It's also spinning with this part.
Okay.
Now comes the most difficult.
It's just great design.
That's all there is to it.
Okay.
And what you have to keep in mind is that the handle on the middle down knot and this knot has to be in one line.
Okay.
As long as you keep it in one line, you can do it like this, even upside down. In the car, as long as you're not a driver. The backseat,
yeah.
Waiting room, train,
having a fight.
Yeah. Because if you don't keep the long line, this is going to happen.
Okay, yeah, I get stuck around there. That makes sense.
Okay. Another thing is that you don't pull it like that. See, so you have to keep it straight, but not tight. Then it goes like there. Then you start all over again. Drafting, pinching, turning, spinning, and then winding
again.
Okay. Your right hand.
Yes.
It's in the right hand. It's in the left hand.
Pinch it.
Keep the one up. May I help you?
Yeah, yeah.
No tension on this.
Okay.
Just go like this.
Hi.
And this is the way. It's even less than
from you.
No, it's fine. Okay. This is what you need. Where we are. So you wind it up.
Okay.
Yep. Use two hands.
Well, you have no choice.
Yeah. This is the most difficult part, because if you do it irregularly, the yarn will come out. Not and then you pull it apart.
Then it's fine.
Yeah, yeah.
Yay! Hey.
Awesome!
Just
keep my hands still. That's really cool!
So you have to, when you start getting tired, you can write a statue of liberty. Go on.
Okay.
So you can do it in the...
You
can do it everywhere. And the drop spin on the end drop, you can't use it.
Oh, you just have to
click. Okay, and then you go... You're not flying.
I've never spun before.
Okay, so if you would start knitting with a single ply, your project will urge to one side, because everything is twisted one side. So what you do, you take two balls of it, and then you is spinning one way and plying
the other way
around. And now what you now have, but you know, you can see the yarn now is neutral.
Okay, yeah.
Now it is everything is so that's all there is to it. And then you've got a yarn like this.
That's really cool. Thank you.
Yeah.
Until you let go.
Hey!
And look what happens if
it's
you
pull it in that way. It goes all so okay.
Okay. One line.
This is how not to do it.
No, you're doing good.
No tension.
No tension.
No tension on that.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah. Point.
That's what I got it.
That's it.
Yay! I got it. I was slow learner, it's okay. And then that's enough?
Yeah, oh yeah, more than enough.
Don't want to over twist it, right?
If you cut over twist, look what happens.
It goes on itself, yeah.
That's my problem. Okay, then
just okay.
And then you think it's okay now. And you know how to check it.
Yeah.
Go like this. Let it go. And if it's perfect. Good. Now it's new.
Okay, I'm gonna get one.
Singing on your why not? Go for it. I don't, so you may as well.
And I want Mina's camera.
It's a really good camera.
It's really, really,
really
nice.
Awesome.
It's so little. I haven't seen this one in real life.
Sorry?
I haven't ever seen this camera in real life.
I know, it was actually, I realised it was really hard to get. I tried to order one online and then I realised it's actually not available in the UK.
Oh.
They were having, the Canon were having some sort of supplier issue because of an earthquake in Japan or something.
Good.
It affected one of the factories that were producing something or other. I ordered it from a company in Hong Kong and it was really good.
Yeah.
Vera has her professional camera equipment.
Oh,
with
yes,
her.
Yes. I have a telephone.
What was it? You call that a ferret on your camera?
Yeah, I brought my little pet ferret. So the G7X is the one that I also love to use. It's an awesome one.
And this is me on my phone because I'm like, I'm not cool and classy like the other ladies, but they're fancy.
Sorry?
Have you bought anything else yet?
And look under the table.
Have you seen all the saddlebags?
It's got everything. Yes. There's, I did have it all out.
There is stuff down here.
There's stuff everywhere. There's some John. I'm so jealous.
Every shot you're going to have of me is me going.
That's more than fine.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Go on.
He's filming.
Yeah, I'm filming, don't worry.
Yes.
So as long as you have the John Arbor knit by number.
You're right, Mel?
Yes. Hello.
And again.
So cute.
Between those crimps, much, much tighter in the crimp, much more crimps to the inch than your long wool or your blue-faced Leicester. And because of that lock structure and the crimp, they're very difficult or more difficult to wet felt. So they're easier fleeces to work straight from the fleece. Just like that.
That's really cool.
And there you go. Now look. The actual spring that's in that just naturally. If you spin Wensleydale, the Tees Water, your Lincoln Longwool, you pull it like that and it's just done. There's just about no give in it. And a lot of those types of wool they'll use for weaving. They'll use them for a warp or a weft because they're so flat. They lay there beautifully until they want to finish that fabric, they lay nice and flat. Whereas your downbreed wool, you've got all the spring to contend with. And also, it doesn't felt very well, so it doesn't fall properly. Because, honey, I think I shrank the sheep. Okay. This breed of sheep is the world's smallest breed of sheep.
Aww.
This is a Wissant. O-U-I-S-S-A-N-T. It is officially the world's smallest breed. Because, you know, I like odd things about sheep. I do quite love my sheep, but I'm not like that. Right, we'll get on with gearing the sheep. Now, the first half, straight into the hind leg. Rocking and rolling. And just like a bigger sheep, I gear it in exactly the same fashion. Over the leg. Now, as we come up the neck here, we're running into a little bit of belting. We've got to be a bit careful as we come up the neck, because there's a lot of really important plumbing just underneath the neck. We don't want to come into conflict with that. It's the old story, the sheep likes the skin, the farmer wants the wool. Ooh, look at that. Now we're almost halfway around the sheep already. And it's really important when I'm shearing a sheep that you hang on to it tightly, isn't it?
Aww.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Aww.
I guess it must be the soft tank. We'll just change tack a little bit, go back in time, and we'll carry on. We'll come right out on the edge here so everyone can see the wonder that is blade shearing. Now this has been going on for almost as long as man has had domestic sheep. Because man, as soon as they domesticated sheep, thought, hey, this wool stuff's excellent. So they bred the sheep selectively from the ones that had a bit more wool. But those ones didn't roam so well. They didn't lose their wool. So they were really working hard to try and rip it off them. Well, that was no good, so they then started cutting it off them. Calm down. Don't get strung out. Now you'll notice I didn't use the big shears on this sheep. And it's not because she's just a little sheep. It's because she's very tight in the fleece. Now these little blades are almost like a spear. You can actually get them through a tighter fleece than the big blades. But the big blades, if you whack them in and fill them up, bang, you can cut lots of wool off at once. But with a tight fleece, you want these little kitties. Is everything once you start shearing with the blades, it all goes a bit zen, really. It's quiet. You're at one with your sheep. And hopefully your sheep senses that.
Bless you.
And there we have the littlest sheep in the world.
No.
Even littler. It saddens me that the wool that I just took off that sheep in years gone by would have kept that sheep all year. Now it barely pays for the shearing. It seems as a society we know the cost of everything and the value of very little at all. But that's just my opinion. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for lending me your ears.
Watched the sheep shearing show and learned a bit more about sheep. Turns out we don't know as much about sheep as we thought we did. And it's actually really interesting, little tiny baby sheep. And well, it wasn't really a baby, it was just a tiny sheep breed. Do you remember what the name was?
Western.
Okay, that one. And yes, that was good fun. Sitting on the grass, sheep in the background.
Slightly
itchy. Yeah. But it's fine. Alright, I think that's it for now. Yeah, check back later. Right, I think we're done for the day. We've kind of just hung out and shopped to our heart's content. We both have, we both have bags of stuff to take home. And yeah, I think we're probably just going to do the last little wander around and try and find our way back to the train station. Yeah, there's a little spinning station up in front. I'll just flip you around so you can see. Whoop. Really lovely weather today. Weather's been really nice. It's been perfect. It's a sheep show in one of the tents. Yeah, so I think we're gonna call it a day. And yeah, I'm not sure when I'm gonna get this up, but hopefully soon. All right, so till next time, bye.